just kind of feel it out. I'm gonna feel it out, like, pretty much all of it, and kind of go based off of that, like, the feel for it. You got any work done before, though?
No.
Not with it for this?
I, you know what, the I did it on a Saturday, and I had a guy come to the house to do my legs on a Sunday, and I had him just work on my shoulder instead. So I got to work every once, the day after it happened.
But like arms and stuff like that, that's cool? Like when you hit arms?
Yeah, yeah, that's fine.
Or even shoulders?
I could do all the dumbbell shit, I just can't do presses, the shoulders. Yeah. I can do all the laterals, the rears, shrugs, no problems. My shrugs kind of hurt, and I went heavy.
Move your arm like you're doing on like chest flies, little dumbbell flies.
Flies?
Yeah.
How's the baby?
Oh, he's good.
Yeah.
He's 3 months this weekend.
Dang.
He's around there.
That fucking fly is on.
Yeah. His sleep is just getting better, too.
I'm sure. Probably gonna wake up once or twice in the air. Probably we get about once or twice right now.
Or like twice.
One night.
Yeah. And then those other stages come in with like, they start getting the teeth and stuff. And
oh yeah.
Start crawling and shit.
Crying all night, all day.
We're looking up like what to give him for his first like actual meal. A lot of people say actually steak is really good for him.
Steak?
Yeah, but it's like almost pretty much raw, you know?
Yeah. Why they chew on it, man?
Yeah.
It's like chewy?
Yeah. It's like a little chewy one, and it says because of all the vitamins and nutrients and all that shit.
That makes sense.
They said like instead of like, you know, giving him like fruit and shit like that, and I was looking into it, and there's a lot of doctors that recommend that.
So you have steak though?
Yeah. You know, like a little piece? You can just cut it into a little piece.
Yeah, yeah,
and, you know, just chew on that shit.
You know, I never understood the whole fruit thing, only because I was high in sugar.
Yeah. Yeah, that's how they say, because it's like steak has pretty much all the nutrients they needed, you know?
Yeah.
So you just cook some steak or whatever and then just give it to them and they'll just like suck on it, you know, and chew on it or whatever.
I never heard of that, that's cool. But I mean, it makes sense, logically.
Yeah. Or liver and stuff like that, you know, like.
Oh, fuck that.
Dude, just tell, imagine, I told my girl, I was like, just imagine telling your mom, you know what I mean? Like,
it's gonna make you trip, you know?
And you like a trip and you give some bananas.
Yeah, right? Then you give the cream of rice and the cream of oatmeal for the carbs.
No, but it's good too though, because then you know when you start giving them those first meals, like they get used to that, so they grow. They're gonna grow up like that, you know.
Yeah.
Instead of, you know, like all this processed shit.
Eating shitty bullshit.
Especially when you give them like you know steak and eggs or shit like that.
Yeah.
He's gonna grow up liking that stuff instead of, you know, something like a 2-year-old into.
Put up all that shit his whole life. I wonder how, like, not his whole life, I guess, yeah, his whole life. Like, I wonder how much stronger he would be, right, by the time he's like 10, 12, you know?
Yeah.
As far as like sports and shit goes, too.
That's what I told my girl, like, she ate, like liver and steak, you know, through her entire pregnancy.
She really?
Yeah, so he looks like he has, like, fucking boulders and shit. And, I mean, this is the first pregnancy she worked out pretty much throughout, you know? So he looks like he has like the shoulders and shit.
Yeah.
I was like, he's probably gonna be like those people that have like the jeans and shit, you know? Like, he's probably gonna be like that.
Right.
I was like, he's probably just gonna like fucking build that shit like naturally, you know?
Yeah.
Especially because we're feeding him like, you know, good stuff.
Yeah.
A lot of it too is because like with my other kids, like, you don't know, you get me? Like back then, like, there wasn't social media or YouTube and shit.
Yeah.
It's way different.
You went off of what your parents did to you.
Yeah. Now it's like so easy to find, like you just find like an Instagram account and like, you know, or whatever.
Yeah.
Put it like all the way up, like kind of right next to your head. Move your arm back and forth, like straight this way.
This way?
Like straight this way. Yeah, like that. Wow. Like more. In the front, right?
Oh, like, fuck, yeah. Fuck.
Still shooting? Still back?
Yeah, kinda.
Yeah. It's releasing on you. You feel your lat's even getting bigger.
It's not as crispy as you do it.
Should I keep moving you if you can? You are?
Fuck, hurts.
Still shoot to the back?
It's just kind of, I think maybe because of the pressure. Maybe me tensing up. I did back that shit too.
Oh, are you sore?
Yeah.
You can you turn to your side facing out?
Yeah. Oh fuck.
Then I'll lift the other one here. Try doing like a lat pull down right there. Is that on it? Doesn't shoot to the back of your shoulder anyway?
Yeah. Was it supposed to?
No, it's not supposed to. That just showing the, it's a trigger point there. Here, I'm just gonna move this. See how this angle. There's that. No, you want to get rid of that though, you know, that pull, that, or that the trigger point that you feel on the shoulder.
Yeah, it just gets,
like a little pull.
It's trying to get any better, but.
You doing the lat pull down? Do the pull down again.
Ah, fuck!
Nah, just leave it there. I think it broke up, so that's good.
Yeah, I feel
you can feel a little bit more in the body, but that mid part, that's where you felt it shooting. It should be releasing it. I don't know if you can tell.
It feels really fucking loose. Yeah. Oh shit, it's about to. Yeah, it feels like really loose.
Yeah, we just keep trying to break this up and then try to get all of it so that way, you know, I can still compensate.
Fuck!
When are you starting your prep? I saw you're starting your prep.
I'm supposed to. Yeah, but that's my, that's, MRI is the time of everything, bro. You know what I mean?
See where it goes from there?
Yeah, if it's gonna be a slight tear, that I need a fucking surgery or something. I don't know. I hope not.
No, but if not, you're starting one too. Like, if it's all good.
Yeah, I mean, if it's gonna start with this. The only thing is, like I said, my press is really, like, literally fucking, like, I'm doing 10% of what I normally do. Oh, fuck! Ah! Oh, fuck! Yeah, I think this Saturday is 18 weeks up.
When are you supposed to start it? 16? If you start.
I wanted to start early, because I've been off cycle. I've been on TRT for going on 6 weeks already. So I really wanted to start early and put weight back on, and then jump into a prep. But normally, like 14, it's like 12, 14 weeks. But I want to do like a small 3-4 week bulk into it. Serena's, huh?
Yeah,
so fuck.
That's like the last of it, though. You feel the rest of it?
Yeah, smooth. Yeah, it's smooth compared to what it was.
Bring your arm down. Let me work on the track from there.
Freeze.
No, like that. How you are?
Oh. If I wasn't wearing these fucking pants, you'd be sliding me down.
You don't feel that shooting to your head right there?
I'm feeling my neck a little bit, back of my ear.
Can I rotate your neck right there? Just like I say? Or yeah, I told you.
You trying to get the stretch down?
What's that?
You trying to get the stretch down?
Yeah. Alright. You'll probably feel it too, like once. When you tilt it? Is the shoes to the
here? No. Ah, fuck. Yeah, I've never felt that fucking pain before.
Do
they need that still shoot, or? When you go
up to
the top of the neck.
Like closer?
It goes back there.
You said it feels a bit better?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
Like once you get there.
Right there. Overall, I feel pretty good. So, let's see how you feel right now when you stand up. I think the main thing was right there, the lad, the subscribe and all that. Thanks a little bit too, but.
See that, do that throw in the front.
Is that going away or still? You still feel it?
It's going away. See, up there from the front. And the old down goes away.
Feels like you broke up though. I don't know. Let me see. Or let me know if you feel it still.
Not nearly as much.
Yeah. I shoot to the front?
Yeah. So I noticed you didn't even dig into the injury. You stay around it, huh? I didn't even dig into the injury.
Yeah, most of the time it's around it. That's what I find with most people. I mean, I'll still go like around the shoulder and stuff like that, but most of the time it's something else, you know?
Yeah.
It's like something that's pulling onto it, you know?
Right.
You see, like, everything around the shoulder is not even that bad, you know? Like, for example, like this right here, you know?
Yeah.
Anything that I've actually, like, I'm just going on the side though too right now, but so the way I picture it is you know how like you picture like a rope attached to like a doorknob?
Yeah.
And like the doorknob is like your shoulder, just think about it like that, you know?
Gotcha.
And then the rope is like the muscle, you know?
Yeah.
So then once you get rid of that, those knots and stuff like that, like it'll get rid of that pull.
Right. And yeah, I get what you're saying.
For the most part, I mean, it works like that. I mean, every now and then, you know, it'll actually be on the joint and stuff like that, but majority of the time it's not. And you can compare the pain too, you know what I mean? Like which one hurts more?
Yeah.
Usually, like those areas I heard more, like the ones you had like in the middle lat area. Those are the ones usually responsible for it. Because they say that injuries like that, like they hold trauma also. So that's why usually they're more painful, you know? They'll hold like because of whatever happened, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They hold trauma. So like, for example, like even ankles. Sometimes I'll have people that like sprain an ankle and then it hurts really bad, you know, because of the trauma and stuff. But then I have someone that's almost like it or even worse. But it just, there's just built up over time, and it's not as bad, you know, it's not as painful.
So the pain causes the trauma?
Yeah, because of the injury, you know what I mean?
Right, yeah.
Like whatever happened, right. You know, however you injured it.
Yeah.
Like a lot of shit with the water, you know? Like, it's just easy to continue learning and change.
Yeah, for sure.
Like some people you can tell that they're clearly worse, you know, but then they'll hurt more or less.
It's the same sprain angle.
Yeah. Like similar, sometimes I can tell like on injuries, so I'll tell them like, oh, it's not even that bad, you know, but yeah. They're being like in extreme pain, you know.
A lot of that's due to the pain level tolerance too.
Yeah, pain tolerance, yeah. And it's like a nervous system too, so it's like, you know, like, which that's like fun and stuff too.
Yeah.
see, but around the actual shoulder, like, you don't really feel much, you know?
Right. When you do that, it shoots a fucking pain in my hand.
Oh, there's a nerve there. I don't see that. Okay.
It feels like it's right going on my vein.
I'll bring it up a little bit. Your Should I do the leg move right there?
So when I did the injury, I found that all that fucking shit was out. Like I found the fibers fucking full. There's so much shit you can fix that you can get lost in the shot.
Yeah. Like I said, I think you got most of it. I mean, if anything, maybe just one more, but it should be pretty good, I feel like. I mean, you can tell there's a lot, like, pretty much everywhere, you know?
It does feel out looser. Mm-hmm. When I was wearing it earlier. It's not going anywhere.
Can I keep moving if you can? The flag? Yeah.